Policy needs to be informed. That's what we do at India Development Foundation. We are a research organization, and we do a lot of work with the multilaterals, governments, with civil society organizations. We do a lot of primary research so that we can do our projects, earn some money, and pay for our independent research such that we can inform policy. So, like Chaitra said, policy should not be just lip service ki man kiya bana diya. What we try to do is we try to work for years, maybe sometimes 1 year, 2 years, run experiments, go to the field, and sort of research evidence just so we can say that these are our recommendations for a policy. So today I'm going to talk about the impact of an adult literacy program on the personal and public lives of women. It's something that I have co-authored with a colleague of mine, Nishant Chadha. Dr. Nishant Chadha is an economist and he's not here today. And like all good men, he has given me the task of presenting this paper. So this paper is going to be published very soon in a SAGE publication. Over and above the project that we've done, we have done some research that shows that this perhaps is a very big problem in India. India has about 19% of the world's global population, but we have 35% of the adult illiterates in the world. In India, there are so many people, if you see the slide, so many of us above the age of 15 who are illiterate. And 41% of women are illiterate. This is huge. This is despite RMSA, RTE, Sarva Siksha Abhiyan. This is a huge problem, and it shows up in the offices that Kalpana was talking about. We don't educate our women. We treat them differently at home, and then suddenly we send them to these offices and hope that Kalpana will solve all the problems. But a lot of the problem is because we're not literate at all to begin with. The program that I talk about is called Tara Akshar Plus. It's a program that was implemented by an agency called Development Alternatives. It's a very prestigious and implementing agency. It's based out of Delhi. This program was run in 3 districts of Uttar Pradesh between 2013 and 16. And we were called in to evaluate this project, which basically means ki bataiye project ka fayda hua ki nahi. What did the project impact? That is what we were hired to do as a research institution that specializes in impact evaluations. And we conducted this towards 2016 end, so towards the end of the program. Now the program is a very simple program. It is a program where for the first 56 days, women learn to read and numbers, read, write and numbers in a 56-day computer-enabled program. After that program is finished, what happens is that they go into something called a post-literacy program for 6 months, where they sort of sit and revise and play games and talk to each other. Now, I say expected outcomes there, and Chaitra had used this thing, unexpected consequences, but I don't use it in that meaning. Expected outcomes here is, aapko paise diye gaye hain ek program chalane ke liye, us program se aapko kya dikhana hai. So the program was very focused. It did not want to change world. It did not want to change the lives of women. It did not want to do anything, but इतनी सारी औरतों को पढ़ा रहे हैं, उनको पढ़ना आना चाहिए, फिर 6 महीने और रिवाइज कराएंगे, तो उसके बाद उनको वो याद रहना चाहिए. That was the only thing. What we studied, however, what we wanted to study was the unexpected consequences as well. So we were basically being paid for this, but we wanted to do a paper also on this. So that's how it was. So our study objectives were very simple. One, तो आप ये बताइए कि पैसों से औरतें पढ़ी लिखी कितना. दूसरा, our own objective that if they have learned to read and write, has it impacted their lives in any other ways? And of course, we always look for recommendations. So the third thing was, if we indeed learned something out of the success of this program, then what could we say were its implications for policy formulation towards solving this big problem, which is illiteracy amongst adult women in India. You know, what we did here is something called sequential explanatory methodology. Sorry, I'm sort of, this is sort of an academic presentation, so I'll very quickly go over these slides. I don't think most people are interested in how we did, how we found out what we found out. So we started with quantitative methodology, where we did a quantitative data collection. Then we did quantitative data analysis. Informed by this analysis, humko pata tha what our surveys are showing, we did qualitative, which is what I do. For this, we did qualitative data collection, which is what I did, through interviews, focus group discussions, in-depth discussions. And then I did my qualitative analysis. Then we sort of got together and did, you know, synthesized all the information that we had, coded it, and then we did our analysis. Now, I think I should skip these slides, because these are basically how we do sampling, how we decide in such a big program that has run and has 150,000 women participated in it. How do we decide who are the women that we are going to survey? So there is a methodology in this, and those who are interested, the paper is for the sharing, and I can talk to you later also about it. But basically, we chose 1,500 respondents as treatment. Matlab 1,500 women were surveyed for this study. Yeah, and then hum jab 1,500 auraton se baat kar rahe hain, and we are asking them some questions. Who are we comparing it with? I'm sort of assuming that not everybody here is interested in sampling again. But the thing is this, that if I am in a weight loss program and she is in a weight loss program, then we have to be comparable to each other. I mean, it cannot be that somebody who is a vegetarian, not a non-veg like me, a man who is taller than me, shorter than me, broader than me, studied differently, I can't compare myself with that man. So these techniques, basically, the econometricians, the economists, the statisticians, they work with us. And what they do is they make sure that agar 1,500 aisi auraton se baat kiya, to the control should be exactly women like that in the neighboring blocks. Sirf farak ye hai that these women went through the program and these women did not go through the program. Similarly, so for that, for the control group, we did 1,200 women. Right? For qualitative, just like in quantitative, you do surveys and you find out what the changes are. In qualitative, what we do is we talk to people. We do something called focus group discussions. We sit with groups of women and talk to these women about what we have found in the quantitative surveys, in the surveys. Now, we use something called purposive sampling, and remember that our qualitative study was to explain what we had found out already in the quantitative. So we did FGDs only in the treatment villages, which means only with women. We only spoke to women who had gone through the program. And we did three such FGDs. We did three such FGDs with 10 women each, so 30 women. Yeah? Okay. Now I will tell you about the findings. So the expected findings. The expected findings was that there was significant difference after the program. The women who had gone through these programs were reading and recognizing numbers and adding and subtracting much better than those who had not gone to the program. Those were the illiterates in the control group, the women who had not gone through the program. The interesting thing, however, was that there were these women who had gone through the program, there were these illiterate women who had never studied at all, and there were the women who were already literate. Now, my colleagues are very excited about this. We discovered a literacy ladder. Again, what we found out is that these types of programs, adult literacy programs, are not a surrogate for actual formal education. You can't just not give women education, but just say that, you know, I'm going to skill them. I'm going to give them adult education and say that, you know, it's the same. It's not the same. Formal education for women is a must. So anything good that these programs do does not mean that these programs can, you know, उसकी कमी नहीं पूरी हो सकती कि आप स्कूल किसी को भेजे नहीं फिर 15 साल के बाद आप बोले कि अडल्ट लिटरेसी प्रोग्राम में जाइए नो देयर इज अ डिफरेंस द अनएक्सपेक्टेड प्रोग्राम द अनएक्सपेक्टेड आउटकम्स वाज व्हाट वाज आई मीन फॉर मी इट वाज माइंड ब्लोइंग सो द फर्स्ट थिंग इज देयर इज सच एन इम्प्रूवमेंट ऑफ सेल्फ इमेज पढ़ी लिखी अनपढ़ में इतना फर्क है अपने लिए आपके बच्चे आपको ज़्यादा सीरियसली लेते हैं आई मीन एक्चुअली देर आर वेमेन इन द FGDs हु टोल्ड मी दैट यू नो मैडम अब तो हमको मेम साहब बोलने लगे हैं जोक्स देर आर बीइंग जोक्स बीइंग क्रिएटेड अराउंड बीइंग पढ़ी लिखी वॉट वी हैड ऑलरेडी चेक्ड इन आर क्वान्टिटेटिव सर्वे वॉज डाउरी हैरेसमेंट एंड डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस वी हैड आस्क्ड रिफ्लेक्शन क्वेश्चंस जब सर्वेयर आपके घर में आता है और पूछता है कि मैडम आपको अगर आपके पति मारते हैं आप कभी हाँ नहीं बोलोगे सो वी हैड आस्क कि अगर आपके नेबर के साथ ऐसा होता है तो आप क्या करती उसमें ऑलरेडी वी हैड सीन कि जो औरतें हमारे प्रोग्राम के थ्रू जा चुकी हैं दे आर ऑलरेडी सेइंग कि नहीं ये अपना मसला नहीं है ये आपका अपना घरेलू मसला नहीं है दिस इज समथिंग दैट इज नॉट जस्ट फैमिली मैटर तो हम कुछ ना कुछ तो करेंगे सो बेस्ड ऑन दैट फाइंडिंग वी हैड लॉन्ग कॉन्वर्सेशंस इन द FGD यू नो अबाउट आप इसको कैसे परसीव करती हैं वुमेन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड कि बहुत कॉमन है बहुत होता है नॉट ओनली कि किसी और का खाविंद किसी और को अगर अपनी बीवी को मार रहा है तो नॉट ओनली इज इट सीन एज पर्सनल मैटर इट इज़ ऑल्सो सीन एज इंटरफेयरेंस मतलब अगर कल्पना मेरे घर में आके कुछ बोलती है तो शी इज़ अ बैड वूमेन शी इज़ इंटरफेयरिंग इन माई यू नो मैटर्स एंड बट द थिंग इज दैट द बिगिनिंग्स ऑफ अ रिकग्निशन दैट दिस शुड नॉट हैपन द फैक्ट दैट अगर ये ऐसा बार बार अगर एक आदमी करता रहा तो हम लोग जाके प्रधान को बोलेंगे हम लोग जाके पुलिस को बोलेंगे पुलिस के हेल्पलाइन के नंबर्स ये जानना कि अगर पुलिस का हेल्पलाइन कॉल करो तो औरत उठाएगी ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स हैड हैपेंड टू द टू आर प्रोग्राम पार्टिसिपेंट्स दे वर टॉकिंग लाइक दिस ओके सो दिस इज इवन दोज हु आर नॉट हियरिंग आई वुड लाइक यू टू लिटिल बिट पे अटेंशन बिकॉज आई थिंक दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फाइंडिंग So what happened is adult literacy programs में सबसे अगर आप literature पढ़ते हैं तो सब लोग literacy में ये बोलते हैं मानना ये है कि जब माएँ पढ़ी लिखी होती हैं बच्चे ज़्यादा पढ़ाती हैं This is the maternal literacy linked to child literacy. So यही समझ के यही पढ़ लिख के हम लोग discussions पे गए थे और हमने बहुत पूछा कि पढ़ाना शुरू कर दिया आप तो अब पढ़ लिख गई हैं आपने पढ़ाना शुरू किया कुछ बच्चों को समझ में आ रहा है सो यस 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 बट नो एंथुजियास्टिक रिएक्शंस क्यों बाद में देखा 30 औरतों में 91 बच्चे हैं 54 स्कूल जाते हैं 41 टू क्लास से ऊपर हैं क्लास टू के अबव बच्चों को somebody who has जस्ट learned रीडिंग एंड राइटिंग पढ़ा नहीं पाएंगी उनके बच्चे अभी 10th में है 7th में एल्गोरिदम्स कर रहे हैं लॉजिस्ट यू नो लॉग फ्रेम्स बना रहे हैं बहुत डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सो एक्चुअली दिस वुमेन आर नॉट बीइंग एबल टू टीच देयर चिल्ड्रन एट ऑल सो केप्ट प्रोडिंग एंड देन वी रियलाइज दैट व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इज दैट अ लॉट ऑफ मदर्स आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द फैक्ट दैट देयर चिल्ड्रन आर हेल्पिंग देम लर्न होमवर्क करा देता है टेस्ट दे देती है मेरी बेटी मैं स्टक हो जाती हूँ ना तो बेटी से पूछती हूँ हम लोग साथ बिल के बैठ के पढ़ने लगे हैं आजकल Yes, so what is happening is this, they have started teaching their children, but they have also started learning from their children. And this is completely not there in the indicators. Nowhere in literature is this mentioned that agar aap maa ko padhayenge, toh wo padhana bhi shuru karegi aur seekhna bhi shuru karegi. So what is happening here is that there is actually an enhanced learning environment. As one of the women told me, घर का माहौल बदल गया है क्योंकि हम साथ मिलके पढ़ने लिखने लगे हैं एंड दिस डजंट जस्ट मीन कि बच्चों को पढ़ा रही है बट बच्चों से पढ़ भी रही है सो दिस इज अ न्यू थिंग एंड वी आर होपिंग टू डू मोर रिसर्च ऑन दिस एंड इन फैक्ट जब हम ये पब्लिश करने के लिए पेपर जब भेजा था तो हमारे रिव्यूअर्स ने हमको बहुत बोला है कि इसको आप थोड़ा और रिसर्च कीजिए और देखिए कि जो माएँ ऐसी पढ़ती हैं उनके बच्चों के स्कोर्स जो हैं वो भी बढ़ते हैं कि नहीं. सो दैट इज that will cost more money, so we'll figure it out, because you know these are actually, I mean, this primary research, so you have to actually sort of follow up, hire people, do all of this. But this is for public outcomes. We saw increased social and political participation, and we actually saw in our quantitative that gram panchayat mein zyada jaane lagi hain, SHG ke membership zyada hain, SHG ka attendance zyada hain. And then through qualitative we wanted to find out the link. Just because कुछ बढ़ गया है ज़रूरी नहीं है कि हमारे प्रोग्राम की वजह से बढ़ा है. वो लिंक्स जब हमने देखे अपने प्रोग्राम के थ्रू, तो सबसे पहले तो हमने ये देखा कि मोबिलिटी ही बढ़ गई है. सोशल मूवमेंट्स आर नॉट पॉसिबल इफ यू नेवर गेट आउट ऑफ होम, अनलेस एंड अंटिल यू आर नेल्सन मंडेला. यू कैन बी इन द जेल एंड स्टिल सॉर्ट ऑफ स्टीयर सोशल मूवमेंट्स. बट जो औरतें बाहर ही नहीं निकल रही हैं, आइदर बिकॉज देयर पेरेंट्स एंड फैमिलीज आर नॉट अलाउिंग, और लाइक शी वॉज सेइंग मेनी टाइम्स दिस इज ऑल्सो सेल्फ इम्पोज. हम खुद भी नहीं निकलती बाहर क्योंकि माहौल खराब है बाहर. So what we realize is the very fact that ye roz class hi jane lagi hain, that in itself has increased mobility, that in itself has sort of given them a new world to look into. Ye these villages basically are sab different bastis hoti hai, thakuron ki basti, panditon ki basti, chamaran ki basti, sab alag alag, and none of these women actually have ever moved out of their bastis. But what we saw is that because of these classes a lot more movement is happening. Women are meeting each other, women are going to each other, studying with each other, and finally this is the biggest outcome, that trust, the whole factor of trust. Ki you know this whole thing ki aap dusron pe believe mat kijiye, village ke bahar ke logon ke sath baat mat kijiye, this is something that is always told to women, and this itself you know saw enhancement both in qualitative and quantitative research. So finally the recommendations are reformulate some of the indicators. Abhi agar aap औरतों को बोलेंगे कि पढ़ लिख लीजिए क्योंकि बस का नंबर देख पाएंगी तो दे आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड. दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट बीइंग एबल टू वर्क द मोबाइल फोन. वो मोबाइल फोन चलाना चाह रही है और वो सोचती है पढ़ लिख जाएंगी तो कनेक्शन फिर से लगाने के लिए बच्चों की हेल्प नहीं चाहिए. देन अपडेट योर मोबिलाइजेशन कैंपेन्स. अगर आप बार बार जाके वही चीज़ें बोलेंगे औरतों को अपने प्रोग्राम में लाने के लिए, वो इंटरेस्टेड नहीं है. दे आर ऑल्सो थिंकिंग इन अ डिफरेंट वे नाउ. दे हैव गॉन अहेड, स्ट्राइड्स अहेड. सो अपडेट द कैंपेन्स, ब्रेक डाउन द प्रोग्राम एज दिस प्रोग्राम इज इनटू स्मॉल पार्ट्स सो दैट फंडर डाइवर्सिफिकेशन कैन हैपन. देन द पॉलिसी एनवायरमेंट राइट नाउ इज सो फुल ऑफ स्किलिंग, वुमेन्स एम्पावरमेंट, मेक लिटरेसी अ पार्ट ऑफ इट. मेनी ऑफ द वे आई एम ऑल्सो डूइंग अ प्रोजेक्ट विद UNDP नाउ, इवेल्युएटिंग एंड मॉनिटरिंग इट, एंड वी आर स्किलिंग 10 लाख वुमेन थ्रू 2 years. But what is the use? Most of these women are not even educated. So use these programs to as remedial learning, literacy programs, and finally NLM is a very good program, the National Literacy Mission. There are very many Zilla Siksha Parishads have great mandates, flexible mandates. Maybe you can do that. And the third, I can't even see myself. And institutionalize some of the things where after learning women get together and speak. Women's clubs have huge power. When women meet together, when they talk with each other, change happens. Thanks.